Dear sirs, it is wrong to demand a new song. I have let all the breath I can spare go. With the muse I've conferred, and she won't say a word, but keeps laughing about the embargo. I wish that I could sing in allegro mood, but the times are as stupid as largo. Could I have my choice, I would strain up my voice till it snapped all the strings of embargo. Our great politicians, those dealers in visions, on paper to all length they dare go. But when called to decide, like a turtle they hide in their own pretty shell the embargo. In the time that we try to put out Britain's eye, I fear we shall let our own pair go. Yet still we're so wise, we can see with French eyes, and then we shall like the embargo. A French privateer can have nothing to fear, she may load and may hear and may there go. Their friendship is such, and we love them so much, we let them slip through the embargo. Our ships all in motion once whitened the ocean, they sailed and returned with a cargo. Now doomed to decay, they have fallen a prey to Jefferson worms and embargo. Lest Britain should take a few men by mistake, who under false colors may dare go. We're manning their fleet with our tars who retreat from poverty, sloth, and embargo. What a fuss we have made about rights and free trade, and swore we'd not let our own share go. Now we can't for our souls bring a hake from the shoals. 'Tis a breach of the 20th embargo. Our farmers so gay, how they galloped away, 'twas money that made the old mare go. But now she won't stir for the whip or the spur, till they take off the clog, the embargo. If you ask for a debt, the man turns in a pet, I pray, sir, I'll not let a hair go. If your officer comes, I shall put up my thumbs and clap on his breath an embargo. Thus Tommy destroys a part of our joys, yet will not let the beautiful fair go. They all will contrive to keep commerce alive, there's nothing they hate like embargo. Since rulers designed to deprive us of wine, 'tis best that we now have a rare go. Then each to his post and see who will do most to knock out the blocks of embargo.
These 12 verses were crafted in 1807 by Henry Mellon, who set them to a widely known tune called Come Let Us Prepare. Mellon, a New Hampshire Federalist, dramatically gives voice to the widespread opposition against the embargo, how and why it harmed our shipping, fishing, and farming. The song blames Jefferson for damaging our country more than the intended target, Great Britain, thus aiding the French. The author also cleverly stretches what rhymes with embargo, providing a bit of comic relief as well.